The most listened to progressive talker in America is back. Here's Ed Schultz.
Mike, great to have you with us, and I appreciate your support for being at the rally on Saturday. Great to have you on.
Ed, I'm still fired up. What a great rally. I'm there, and I'm watching this. This is the first serious, now think about this, the first serious pushback from progressives that we have seen since Obama's inauguration. Now, that sounds bold, but it's the truth. For two years, Democrats have endured, this insane loony babble coming from the right, and we've sat there on our hands. But not Saturday.
How would you characterize the crowd?
I would here's how it was. When you asked, do you care about America? What I saw this theme coming out from that crowd where it wasn't just, yes, we care about America. It's, hell yes, we care about America, and we're showing up to do something about it. I see the John Avalons from Daily Beast. I see some of these people try to characterize this crowd as, spooky and wingnut. No, the people I talked to had driven 5 hours with their children. They were teachers. They were labor unions. They were there with their children so their children could see how democracy works. And I got to tell you, Ed, I'm not just blowing smoke here. When I stood there in that crowd and you gave that speech and you reminded them that there's nothing about the right wing that gives them control of spirituality in America or patriotism in America, and you reminded that crowd that we have to speak up, those people responded. There was nothing loony about it. There was nothing wingnut about it. And I got to tell you something. When I see the John Avalon, I call him Tokyo Rose. What he is, he's one of these guys that are always spewing, telling the story as if he's a middle of the road objective observer about what's happening in American politics. When you really dig down, the guy's just another disguised, dressed up right winger. But, as I look at the reviews on all this, they did get it. They understood the American union workers were there to push back, that all we've heard is this consistent, simple, clear message that for the first time we started hearing it, where Americans clearly understand that a handful of Wall Street mega corporations are wanting to buy this election. They want to outsource jobs. They want to continue to bust up labor unions. They want to stack the tax systems to where corporations don't pay tax, but everybody else does. Those are the things you covered in your talk. Those are the things that you covered and people responded to. And when you talked about outsourcing jobs, the crowd went crazy because that is the number one concern for Americans nowadays. And that's not an Obama problem. That is a right-wing Republican issue. That's how they have paid back the Republican money machine by allowing them to outsource jobs and then not only allow them to outsource jobs, but give them tax benefits to do it. Those are the things you talked about. This crowd responded. They understood. There was nothing odd about this crowd at all. These were middle America, had driven from all over this country. They were mothers, fathers, children that understand that when you stood up and you said, do you care about America? Man, it was just, it was overwhelming, the response from that crowd.
It was, there was something going through my spine I had never felt before.
it was a
lifetime thrill to be up there on the Lincoln steps speaking for a lot of Americans and trying to motivate the crowd that it is all about November 2nd. I've never been to a rally like this. I've never been to something where there's 200,000 people.
I haven't either. I'm standing there watching you deliver this great speech, but I'm in the crowd, Ed. You understand? I'm down there and I'm listening and I'm seeing the emotion that is all over that crowd. And I got to tell you something. If you wanted to see 200,000 real patriotic Americans that understand they're not there to be paid for by Wall Street. These are people that build things, they make things, they build buildings and cars and they manufacture things. They're not Wall Street. They're not the Teabagger paid for group from Wall Street who on a good day, they're going to manufacture CDOs, swaps, and derivatives and steal from the U.S. economy. These are people who are the backbone of this country. And they understood, as you stood up there and you empowered them, you said, look, what is it we have to do? This is the first time we've met in 2 years, Ed. It's the first time Democrats have been there for 2 years. And what did you tell them to do? The only thing we can do, votes overcome money. I don't care how much money you put into it, and they're putting millions. I mean, you've got Karl Rove. The guy should be in handcuffs, for God's sakes. He's out there working for Fox News and out trying to raise money for the Republicans, and he's raising a lot. $82 million here, $50 million there, $30 million there. But you know what? It is the Mitt Romney story. We can overcome that simply by showing up at the polls. That's what you empowered them to do at that rally. They came away. Look, hey, I want one last story. I'm walking out. This woman's coming. She's walking in. She's got her children with her. I said, well, you know, what are you here for? She didn't know what it was, but she wanted to hear Ed Schultz. I said, I'm sorry. You missed it. She kept on walking. But the point is this. You did what you wanted to do. I got to tell you something. You may not have felt pressure, but I felt pressure for you leading up to this thing. I knew that you wanted to have the kind of crowd that you ended up having. And but you delivered, man. I'm telling you.
Well, there were One Nation rallies all over the country in certain cities, and we're going to highlight that tonight on the Ed Show on MSNBC, and we're going to show the speech. We're going to show the crowd. It is to motivate Americans that despite the sound culture of the country, despite the negativity on the agenda to keep this country moving forward for the middle class and for working folks, we're out there. We can get this done. Nothing's lost until we give up. And I was energized by this crowd. There were so many passionate people. There were so many people there that just loved America and just wanted to be a part of it. They know what the stakes are. They know what the stakes are. And everybody I talked to, I said, we got to keep going. You know, we can't back down. We have to make sure that we close this deal. And the deal is to give the Democrats the majority, give the progressive agenda a chance. And I think it could be a better second 2 years if we can get in a position where we hold the majority. And look, we know what they're going to do. They've said no to everything. They're going to continue to say no until they get the majority.
And, you know, that
really is it, Mike.
The short list is incredible. The short list is they want the United States out of the UN. They want to shut down teacher unions. They want to end Social Security. They want to end Medicare. They think rats have human brains, so they want to do studies on that. They want to end the American labor movement. They want to lower tax for billionaires. They want to start a war with Iran. They want to end government stimulus. They want to reverse executive order legislations about climate change. That's just the short list, Ed. Add to that, they want to ban alcohol. That really pissed me off. But at any rate, I got to tell you, This is an agenda that it sounds like something out of the 20s and the 30s, leading up to the McCarthy era in the 50s. That's the kind of agenda that these people want for America. And I got to tell you, the group that I saw there in Washington, D.C., was a group that is starting the pushback, and the pushback is going to be dramatic. And I do believe they're going to show up. I don't think there's any – I'll tell you what, there's nobody at that rally – that took place in Washington, D.C., that's not going to be at the polls. And that's just the first time we've pushed back. We got to continue between now and November.
Mike, great to have you with us here on the Ed Schultz Show. Appreciate your friendship and your support so much. Let's just keep going, buddy. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Ed.